Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are going to discuss paper code 871. This is test series, online test series, and in this test series we provide 100 tests, code number 851 to 900, and all test paper and all questions of every test will have video explanation. So if those students who want to join this test series, they can join immediately. Question number 51 to 75. In this portion, we will cover this is mathematical portion. Question number 51. If x plus y plus z is equal to 6, then the value of x minus 1 plus y minus 2 plus z minus 3. If you see expression in this format, you must have learned one formula, that is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 0 when x plus y plus z is equal to 0. Now see in this expression, if we take in this expression x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2 and z is equal to 3, then it will become 0. X plus y plus z, that is we will have 6, but this expression we will have x minus 1. You can say this plus this plus this, x plus y plus z, you can say a plus b plus z, c is equal to 0 if we put the value of this, and this is also satisfying this expression. So it means x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, and c, z is equal to 3. We can think in that term also. So then we will have a cube plus b cube plus c cube will be equal to when a plus b plus c is equal to 0. In this case we have 0, then a plus b and c is equal to, you will find this expression. So this option c is representing this 3, a, b and c. So answer would be c. Question number 52. A motor boat in still water travels at a speed of 30 km per hour. It goes 56 km upstream in 1 hour 45 minutes. The time taken by it to cover the same distance 56 km down the stream will be, this is against the stream. So you can say against the stream in 1 hour and 45 minutes. You can say per kilometer per hour would be, then you can say 1 hour 45 means 7 by 4, 32 km per hour is the speed, and which is upstream speed, and 36 is still water speed, 36 is still water speed, and 32 is upstream. It means 4 km per hour is current speed, 4 km per hour is current speed. So still water speed plus current speed, 30 plus 4, that would be downstream speed, 40 would be the downstream speed, and we have to tell how much time for 56 km will be traveled by that boat if the speed of downstream is 40. So 56 divided by 40, 7/5 hour, which is equal to 1 plus 2/5. You can write into, if you multiply it by 60 to make it minute, then we will have 1 hour 24 minutes. C should be the answer. Next question, question number 53. Find maximum value of sine 6 60 degrees plus cos 6 60 degrees. Now sine 6 is equal to root 3 by 2. I put here 6, and here cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2, because sine 30 is equal to cos 60, and we will have 6. So you can say 1 by 2 into 6, you, in other words, you can say 3 power 3, that is 27 divided by 2 power 3 into 2, you can say 64 plus 1 by, again you can write this into is equal to 2 power 3 into 2, which is 8 into 4, 64, 28 by 64, that is 7 by 16 should be the answer. And in option there is no 7 by 16, it means none of these should be the answer. Question number 54. In the question, in the given figure, it is given AB parallel to QR. This is AB and this is QR. Find the length of PB. We have to find the length of this, and this length is given. So use the property. Which property? Take it as x. X divided by 6. Why? Because what is the property? Property is, if I write only property, then PB divided by PR and AB divided by QR. This is the property in this particular case which will be used. We have then x plus 6, which is equal to 3 by 9. You can say x is equal to 2. So answer should be A. Question number 55. A begins a business with rupees 450 and is joined afterward by B with rupees 300. After how many months does B join if the profit at the end of the year is divided into the ratio 2:1? This question is related to partnership. And partnership question, A begins with the business 450 and is joined afterward B by rupees 300. How many months does B join if the profit at the end of the year is divided into 2:1? 2:1. So remember always, profit, if it is 2:1, profit is always in the ratio of investment. So investment in this case would be, investment in this case, if this is 2, at the end of 1 year, 1 year means if I divide by 12 to make it equivalent investment, then it would be, you can write here, then it would be equivalent investment would be 5400 and 2:1, it means it should be 2700 equivalent investment after this 1 year. But B invested 300 rupees, it means 300 into 9 is 2700. It means 9 months of B money remained as investment. So it means after 3 months B joined and remained in the business for 9 months. So after 3 months should be the answer. Answer is B. Question number 56. If the length of a shadow vertical tower is 1 by root 3 times of its height, then find the angle of elevation of the tower. What is the question? Question is given in this format. Length of the shadow of the vertical tower is 1 by root 3. Time of its height. Then find the angle of elevation. We have to find this. Now, if this is 1, then it would be 1 by root 3. You can say this divided by this is tangent theta. It means I can write here because 1 by root 3 and tangent theta, that is root 3, tangent 60 should be equal to root 3. Answer is C. A man sells a cow at a profit of 8%. If he had bought it at 20% less and sold for rupees 640 more, he would have given 40%. Find the initial selling price of the cow. This is very important question. Sometimes friends, those who are doing first time, they find it difficult, but understand this technique how to solve, you will find this question easy. A man sells a cow at profit of 8%. Let's say 100 is the cost price and 8% is the profit, that is 108 is the selling price. 1 if he had bought 20% less, instead of 100, if he had bought in 80 rupees, 20% less, 80 rupees, then he would have gained 40%. It means 40% is the profit in this case. Profit is 40%. Then we will have 80 into 140, 112 is the SP2. It means selling price is 4 rupees more. Selling price is 4 rupees more. Then what is question is, find the initial selling price. Initial selling price 108. If selling price is 4 rupees more, then initial price 108. If it is 1, then 108 divided by 4. And if it is 64, then it would be, you can say, one seven two eight zero should be the answer. The answer is D. So this is very important question, and we have used in this question, we have used trick, that is pentagon trick. Go to my video basic lectures and you will find over there this trick for these questions. Question number 58. In a division sum, the division is 4 times the quotient and twice the remainder. Let's see. In a division sum, division is 4 times the quotient. 4 times the quotient, what does it mean? It means that if it is A, then it would be A by 4. This is the division. 4 times the quotient and twice the remainder. It means remainder is A by 2. Or otherwise, you can write here A, that is 4A, and that is 2A. 4A, 4A, and that is 2A is the remainder. If A and B are the divisor and the dividend, A is divisor and B is dividend, respectively. This is, we call it dividend, this is remainder, this is quotient, and this is divisor. Then which one is true? So we have to find this and this. You can say multiply of this and this plus A by 2. Plus A by 2. Multiplication of this plus A by 2 is equal to always B, that is dividend. Now we have to find the expression which is correct. So you can say, you can write here A square divided by 4 plus 2A divided by 4. You can write here 2A divided by 4. Or in other words, A square 2A divided by 4, you can write is equal to B. So this is equal to, you can write here A plus 2 and B is equal to 4. This expression can be written in this term, which is the answer D. D should be the answer. So important thing in this question is that you learn this. What is dividend? What is divisor? What is dividend? What is quotient? What is remainder? And multiplication of these two and divide plus addition of a remainder, it will give the result. Question number 55. A train passed a telegraph post and bridge 420 meter long in 8 seconds and 20 seconds respectively. What is the speed of the train? Now in this question it is given that suppose length of train is x, length of train is x, and it is a train passing a telegraph post and a bridge 420 meter long in 8 seconds. If it is passing in 8 seconds, it means this is the length, that is distance divided by time, it is the speed of train, x by 8. Now question is, if this is the length of the train plus 420, this is the length of the bridge, and this is the total distance. If I divide the total distance by speed, that is x by 8, we will have total distance divided by speed, that is time, and time in this case is 20 seconds. So you can say x plus 420 is equal to 20 into x by x by 8. Or in other words, you can say cross multiply, you will have 3x is equal to 840, x is equal to 280. What is x? X is the length of the train, and length of train is 280. We have to find the speed of the train, which is equal to 280 divided by 8. 280 divided by 8. So it will be equal to 35 km per hour. 35 km per hour is the answer. No, 35 cannot be answer because this is in kilometer and this is in meter per second. So this is 35 meter per second, and you want to convert into kilometer per second, then you will have to multiply it by 8 by 18 by 5. Then we will have kilometer per hour, and kilometer per hour would be 126 kilometer per hour. So C should be the answer, not A, because question is asked in kilometer per hour, not in meter per second. Now question number 60. If sine 4 theta plus cos 4 theta is equal to 2 sine square theta into cos square theta, then we have to find the value of tangent theta. Now in this question it is given clearly, sine 4 theta, if I take to this side, then it will be minus. So in other words, sine square theta minus cos square theta square of this would be equal to 0, because if I open this bracket, you will find sine 4 theta plus cos 4 theta minus 2 sine square theta cos square theta, and which is equal to 0, because I have taken from this expression to this side. So this is equal to sine square theta minus cos square theta is equal to 0, and this we can write here in place of this sine square theta minus 1 minus sine square theta, because sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 0. So you will find here sine square theta minus and minus, that is plus. 2 sine square theta you can write here, which is equal to 0. In other words, 2 sine square theta is equal to 1, and sine square theta would be, sine theta would be 1 by root 2, that is 45 degree. It means theta value is 45 degree, and we have to find the value of tangent 45. Tangent 45 would be equal to 1. So answer in this case is 1. Question number 61. If A and B can do a piece of work in 10 days and 60 days respectively, after working together for 3 days, both of them left the job. C arrived and completed the rest of the work in 2 days. C can alone complete the work in how many days? Now take work A and B. Take LCM 6 and 10, that is 30. You can take total work we have taken as 30. So in 10 days, A is completing the work and B is completing 6 days. In other words, 1 day efficiency is 3 unit and 1 day efficiency of B is 5 unit. And both of them will do 8 unit in 1 day, but they have done the work together for 3 days. So you can say 24 units they have already worked. It means 6 unit has left. 6 unit work left, and that is done by 2 by C in 2 days. 6 by 2, that is 3 units per day is the capacity of a 3 unit per day is the capacity of C. 3 units per day. Now question is, C can alone complete the same work. Now 30 is the total work, and 3 unit per day is the capacity of C. It means C will complete the work 30 unit in 10 days. Answer is D in this case. Now question number 62. An electric pump can fill a tank in 3 hours. Because of a leakage in the tank, it took 3 plus 1 by 2 hours to fill the 3.5 hours to fill the tank because of the leakage. If the tank is full, how much time the leakage will take to empty it? A and A minus B, you right, because here there is a leakage and A is filling 3 hours, then B, A minus B will take more than 7 by 2, that is 3.5 hours. Take the LCM, or you can say multiply it all multiply 3 into 7 into 2. Why we are multiplying in this way? So that there is no fraction when we divide it. So total is 42. Let us take capacity 42. You can also take 84 or other number, but it should be it should not give the fractional value. So 1 day or 1 hour efficiency is 42 divided by 3, and 1 hour efficiency in this case would be 3/7. If you 16 into 3, that is 18. 42 divided by 7/2, that is 18. It means in 1 hour, A is filling 40 units, but when B is also opened, then A and B both will take 18 units. See, just a minute, this is 3, and then we have taken, so this is 2, and when A and B, 2 by 7, if A and B both are working, then 42 into 2/7, that is 12 units in 1 hour will take place. What does it mean? It means that 2 units of work has been lost. And what does it mean? That 2 units is the leakage per hour. So if there is only leakage, then it will take 21 hour to empty the entire tank, because the total capacity is 42, and in 1 hour it is taking 2 units. So 42 divided by 2, that is 21 days will be the answer. Answer is in this case B. Now question number 63. In the given figure, find CBA. We have to find the value of this. And in this question, we have given, all these things are given. Now see, how will we find this? Now if this is 75, then it would be 105, because this is a straight line and one angle is 75, then it would be another angle would be 105. And if this angle is 105 and this angle is 30, it means both would be 135. So what would be this angle? This angle would be equal to 180 minus 135. That is 180 minus 135. So 45 should be this case. 45 is this angle. If this is 45, then it would be 135. If this is the case 135, and this would be, because in a circle, sum of opposite angles should be 180. It means this angle should be, if this is 75, then it would be 105. And if this is 105, then it would be 75. And if this is 75, and let me, if this would be 135, and it would be 45. This is 45. So this is straight line. So now in this question, this is 75, this is 45, then we can find value of this. Now 75 plus 45, 120. It means this should be the 60 should be the value in this case. Question number 64. A hollow cylinder made of wood has thickness 1 centimeter, while its external radius is 3 centimeter. If the height of the cylinder is 8, find the volume of, in fact, the wood. Now this is the cylinder, and this is given 1 centimeter. Outer is 3 centimeter. And inner is 2 centimeter, you can say radius. So we have to find the volume. In fact, we have to find the volume of wood. because otherwise there was no need to give inner radius. That's why we have to find. From this we can interpret that we have to find the volume of a wood. Now what should be the in this question, and this is pi r square h minus pi r square h, outer volume, inner volume. In other words, you can write in this format also, because height is same, r square minus r square, and 22 by 7, h is given 8, and then we will have 3 into 3, 9, and 2 into 2, 4, 9 minus 4, that is 5. So you can say 880 divided by 7 should be the answer. Answer in this case B. Now question number 65, a sum of money is lent at x percentage per annum for 3 years. If the same amount is lent at x plus 3% per annum for the same time, then rupees 1296 more interest is obtained. Find out the sum. It means this more is due to 3%. In other words, for 3 years, you can say in 3 years, 1296 per year, you will say 432 rupees is the interest due to this 3%. In other words, SI into 100 divided by time we have taken, we have converted into 1 year, and percentage is 3%. Time 1 year and percentage 3 years, then we will have the sum. Then we will have the sum. Sum would be in this case, then C should be the answer. Question number 66. A tabulator while calculating the average marks of 200 students of an examination by mistake enters 46 instead of 64. 46 instead of 64. What does it mean? It means that the original average is more, because 64 minus 46, 8 is in taking less, and obtained the average is 57. The actual average would be how much? It means it should be more than 57, and how much more? That is 18 is the total, and this is divided amongst 200 students. So you can say 9/100 is more. 9/100 means 57.09 should be the actual average. Question number 67. Price of tea increased by 32%. And so a housewife expenditure on tea also increases by 10%. If she bought 10 kilograms earlier, what is the quantity bought now? Now, for example, she bought 10 kilograms earlier in 100 rupees. Let's take 100 rupees. Why we are taking 100 rupees? Because it is given that the price of tea is increased by 32%. It means earlier she was in 100 rupees 10 kilograms, that is 10 rupees per kg. 10 rupees per kg was the earlier price. Now price of tea increased 32. It means 13.2 is the now new price, 13.2 rupees per kg. And expenditure, house expenditure on tea also increased by 10%. It means instead of 100 rupees, now the expenditure is 110 rupees. So total expenditure is 110 rupees, and price is 13.2 rupees per kg. So expenditure divided by price per kg, we will have kilogram amount of kilogram amount, that is kilogram. So 110 divided by 13.2, you can write here 10. It will be go by 11. So 100 by 12. In other words, you can say 25/3 should be the 20/3. A should be the answer. What we have done is in this case that this is 10 kilogram which is given. Let's take this 10 kilogram investment is 100 rupees. It means per kg is 10 rupees per kg is the price. 10 rupees per kg is the price. Now the price is increased by 32%. It means now the new price is 13.2. And investment is 10% more. It means instead of 100, then investment is 110. So in 110, it is coming 13.2 kilogram. So 13.2 rupees per kg. So how many kilogram will come after this increase? Then 110 divided by 13.5 number of kilogram we will have. 8, 1 by 3 kilogram. Answer is 8. Question number 68. Direction is given. Study the following graph carefully and answer the question that follow. Now, muscle 1 by 3, skin 1 by 10, bones 1 by 6, hormones, enzymes and other protein is remaining part. Protein 16%, other dry element is given, water 70%. What is the question? Question is, in the human body, this is the graph of human body, what percentage of body is made of neither bones, nor skin, nor muscles? What percentage of a body? Muscle, skin, and bone. So you can say which part? 1 by 3. Plus 1 by 2, 1 by 10 and 1 by 6 will have 30, 10, 18 by 30 is made up of all these, or in other words 6 by 10. You can say 60% is this portion, 16% is this portion. Question is, you know, what percent of body is made of neither bone nor skin or nor muscles? It means 40%. A should be the answer because the remaining part is 40%. Question number 69. What is the ratio of the distribution of protein in the muscles to that of the distribution of protein in the bones? Muscles and bone. Muscle and bones. It should be ratio in the same proportion. That it means 1 by 3 and 1 by 6 ratio. In other words, you can say 2 is to 1 should be the ratio, because more the component of muscles, more should be the percentage of protein in this. So 2 is to 1 should be the answer. Question number 70. What will be the quantity of water in the body of person weighing 50 kilograms? Total weight is 50 kilogram, but the 70% is water. So 50 into 70%, that is 35 kg should be the 35% should be the water component. Answer is B. Question number 71. In this question, it is given to show the distribution of protein and other dry element. Protein and other dry element. The arc of circle should subtend and center an angle. We have to find in terms of angle. Now total angle of the circle is 360. It means this is 30% total, because 70% is this, then this would be 30%. 30 means out of 100 it is 30, then out of 360 it would be equal to 108. 108 degree is the angle. This, because this is 30% of a 360 degree. Question number 72. If income tax increases by 19%, income tax increases by 19%, then the net income decreases by 1%. Original rate of income tax is how much? Now this question you can do by two way. One is through option technique, that is more easier, but you need experience for that. Another is through by the expression. Now what is given? Try to understand this. Original rate of income tax we have to tell. Suppose earlier the income is 100, and on 100 income tax is, for example, X percentage. Now this is the net income, 100 by minus X, this is percentage. This is percentage. 100 minus X, this is the net income, because total income minus tax, that is net income. What is the question? If income tax increases by 19%, if this is increased by 19%, means 119 by 100. What does it mean? 119 by 100, that is 1.19 will be the total now. In other words, you can also write 1.19 instead of this. You can write 1.19x. Now, if this is, it means it is, now the income would be less. Income 100 minus, because it has increased. Now the income is reduced. And how much is income reduced? It is reduced. Is saying that it is saying that 100 minus x, this was earlier income. Now this reduced 1%. It means it has become 99% of earlier. You can say 99% of earlier. So what we have done, this was earlier income. Now the new income is, the tax is increased in this way, then income would become 99/100 of earlier income. In other words, you can write 10,000 you can write minus 119x. And if this is 100 this side, then that side 900 99x is equal to 100. You can cancel. We'll have 100. If you go this side, then it will be 20x would be equal to 100. X is equal to 5. So 5% was the tax. 5% was the tax. Value of x we have found 5. So this was the question. But if you want to do and you have experience a little fast, then what you will do? Take 100% is total 100 rupees income and tax is 5%. Take from the option. You can directly take also 5%. Otherwise you take 20, then it will nowhere be close. So it will be 100 and tax is 5%. That is, now income is 95 and tax is increased 5%. It means 5 is increased 90%. That is, now that 0.95 is tax more. In other words, the income is now 94.05, because 100, from 100 it will be, if the tax is 0.95 is the tax, now the income is reduced by 95 paisa. It means net income is now 94.05. you can say income is reduced 95 paisa on 95 on 95 paisa on 95. That is you can write here, that is 1%. It means income is reduced by 1%. It means, what is mean? This is showing that 5% is, if you put 5%, then this equation is justifying. This equation is meeting all the requirement. So 5% the answer. You want to do by option, but you should have experience to solve through this technique. It will be faster. Otherwise, you can solve also this. It will not take much time. Question number 73. In the figure given above, LM is equal to is parallel to QR. Is parallel to QR. If LM divide the PQR, LM divide the PQR. This is the triangle. Such that area of trapezium. This is trapezium. LMRQ. This is trapezium. Is 2 times the area of PLM. This, if suppose area of this is 1 cm², then this would be 2 cm². It means total area would be 3 cm². Then we have to find the value of, what is the ratio of PL and LQ. We have to find the value of this and this ratio we have to find. Now remember, this property would be used in this case, that in case of similar angle triangle, this is similar and entire this QPR, this is LPM, these are 2 similar triangle, then we will have area of ratio of the area of these 2 triangle would be equal to the square of the ratio of the area of these 2 triangle. You can write here 1 by 2 1 by, total is 3, because this is 3. You can write here 3. So their corresponding side ratio would be 1/√3, because the corresponding side ratio is ratio of the area would be square of the corresponding side of the similar triangle. So if the area is this, then the corresponding side would be 1/√3. This is the property. This is the similar triangle property. So if this is 1, it means this is 1, then it would be total, would be total means from this to this root 3, and if I subtract root 3 minus 1, that it means we will have root 3 minus 1 is the value of this, and this is equal to 1, which is given. This is 1 and this is root 3 minus 1, total is root 3, total is root 3. So root 3 minus 1 divided by 1, root 3 we have to find, then the PL is 1, and root 3 minus 1 is QL, root 3 minus is QL, so B should be the answer. In this case we have used this property. What is this property? This is the property, area of two similar triangle, the ratio is equal to, if we take the root of this side, is equal to root of the side, or you can say it is proportional to the square of the side, corresponding side, area is square of the corresponding side, so it 1 by root 3, total is root 3, then it would be equal to root 3 minus 1. Question number 74. Three successive discount, 40%, 30% and 20% is equivalent to a single discount. Now you can use important trick here, 40% plus 30%. This is what is successive, what is a discount? Discount is this. Now take first of these two, we will have minus 12, 14 into 30 divided by 100, 40 into 30 divided by 100. So we will have 40 plus 30, 70, you can say 70, 60, 58. This is 58, and we have to find then this, now consider as x and take is this as y. So x plus y minus xy by 100. So you can say 5.8, reduce 5.8. 58 plus 20, 78 and 5.8 minus, you reduce this, you will have 58 plus 20, let me write again, 58 plus 20, and this is x into y divided by 100, it will be equal to, you can say 11.6. So 58 plus 20, 78 and minus 11.6, 66.4 should be the answer. Answer is C. So what we have used in this question, x plus y minus xy 100 is the successive discount formula, and when we have done of 1, 40%, 30, then take it as x, and after that x plus y. Question number 75. Tangent 2 theta minus point tangent 4 theta is equal to 1. Now if you take theta is equal to 15, then tangent 30 it would be, and that would be tangent 60. So tangent 30 and tangent 60 is equal to 1, which is satisfying this equation. It means tangent value of theta is 15. So we have to find the value of tangent 3 theta. This is the question. We have to find the tangent 3 theta. Theta value is 15. So 15 into 3, that is tangent 45. And tangent 45 is equal to 1. Answer is D. Otherwise, you can also do by tangent 2 theta, and this is 1 by tangent. You can say 1 by tangent 4 theta. You can bring to this side 1 by tangent 4 theta is equal to, you can write cot 4 theta. Or to cot 4 theta, you can write 90 minus 4 theta. 90 minus 4 theta. And this side is tangent 2 theta. You can say 6 theta is equal to 90, theta is equal to 15. You can also do like this. If theta is 15, then tangent 3 theta is equal to tangent 45, which is equal to 1. So answer would be 1. Now in this way we have covered all questions of this paper code, mathematics related questions we have covered. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.